संगत जी, आज के सत्संग की शुरुआत करते हैं और इनवाइट करते हैं डॉक्टर पनम आंटी को। पनम आंटी, प्लीज आए और सत्संग की शुरुआत करें।
थैंक यू सो मच गुरुजी फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टुडे टू डू सत्संग। गुरुजी की वडियाई इज, आई थिंक वी आर द मोस्ट लकी वंस दैट वी गेट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डू गुरुजी की वडियाई, जो किसी भी फॉर्म में की जाए, सत्संग किसी भी फॉर्म में सुना जाए या किया जाए, इट्स अ ह्यूज ब्लेसिंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। आई थिंक द संगत मेंबर्स कैन ट्रूली अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ सत्संग। सत्संग सुनते सुनते ही लोग ठीक हो जाते हैं, गुरुजी के मंत्र जाप ही सुनते सुनते सब ठीक हो जाते हैं। इट इज अ बिग डील फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट विद द सत्संग विच हैपेंड लास्ट टाइम। आई जस्ट वेरी अनकॉन्शियसली सेड दैट इन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इटसेल्फ, आई जस्ट वेरी अनकॉन्शियसली सेड कि मैं आई जस्ट वॉन्ट दैट मेरी लाइफ की गड्डी गुरुजी ड्राइव करे और मैं बैक सीट पे बैठूं आराम से। एंड दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड जस्ट अनकॉन्शियसली। एंड राइट आफ्टर 3-4 days गुरुजी केम इन माय सिस्टर्स ड्रीम एंड शी सॉ दैट गुरुजी इज ड्राइविंग द कार एंड मी, माय सिस्टर भव्या एंड माय ब्रदर सूरज वी आर सिटिंग एट द बैक सीट एंड गुरुजी ड्राइव फॉर अराउंड 30-45 minutes। एंड व्हेन शी टोल्ड मी अबाउट दिस ड्रीम, I just thought about it that how unconsciously I said this remark and how Guruji actually showed it that that's what he's doing. He's actually driving all of our cars and he's taking care of our lives. And how miraculous it is. It has like two significant things attached to it. First is that how with that we just think that yes, you know, in very remorseful times, I used to tell myself that if anything goes wrong, I know that Guruji is driving my car. So I don't need to worry about anything at all. And so now I start with my satsang. The first time I heard about Guruji was from my mother. And she told me that, so Panam, we are going to this Guruji. Unka jo mandir hai, wo Chhatarpur mandir ke aage hai. And the mandir is divine, it's beautiful, it's white in color and it's so beautiful that the light reflects from the marbles. So when I heard about it, I was taken aback. Although I did think, since my dad was suffering from a very bad disease, I did think that this is just another door that we are going to knock for another 6 months. Since we were trying everything out, this was just another thing that we are going to see. And little did I know that it was that door which was going to open all doors for us. So right after that, we started going to Guruji. And I remember I had just appeared for my MBBS ka exams. I don't even remember when I thought of becoming a doctor. And that was the time I had given my MBBS ka exams. And I was just an average student. And I had only qualified the BDS ka seat from Manipal University. And I got scholarship in BDS ka seat, and I somehow made peace with it that I'll just do BDS and maybe that's what is meant for me. And I was wait listed with a wait listing number of 117. Since 7 is a part of that number, I always thought that there was something Guruji was doing all behind everything. So after that, after 2 months of doing BDS, my dad got a call that this student of ours is selected for MBBS and you've got just 10 minutes to decide whether you want the seat or not. And that's where it comes that mom dad had already been going to Guruji and obviously it was Guruji behind getting me the MBBS seat. Right after that, since I was very far with my exams of that semester and I joined MBBS pretty late, I had to appear for my exams now and I wasn't even prepared for it. And the first practical exam of anatomy that I had to give, I was very scared of it since I hadn't even read about it. And so right before the exam, my father told me the importance of Guruji's mantra jap and he introduced me to it that, Panam, remember this mantra jap. इट सेज दैट ओम नमः शिवाय शिवजी सदा सहाय, ओम नमः शिवाय गुरुजी सदा सहाय. I just remembered that mantra jap and went ahead with my exam. So the most tough part about this exam was that the anatomy teachers were really strict, and if you didn't know the answer, they would shout at the top of their voices, and everyone could know in the dissection hall that yes, this student doesn't know anything. So that's what I didn't want, and that's all I had asked from Guruji, that I don't know whether I pass this exam or I fail this exam. I just don't want the teachers to shout at me. And right then, we were given chits on the examination table, and we had to pick up those chits and find out which specimen. Specimen is the body part that you're getting to examine, and go and we'll be asked questions about the nerves, vessels, everything. So when I picked up the chit and I opened it, it was number 7. And when I turned it around, it said sole of foot. So sole of foot was one thing that I hadn't read. And I thought that this is impossible. It will be impossible for me to answer, since I had read from all the body parts from head to toe. But sole of foot was the last chapter of my book. And that's what I missed on. And so then I recalled what my dad had told me, Guruji's mantra jap. And I remembered Guruji, and I kept on doing the mantra jap. So when my chance came and I had to go and stand on that table number 7, I went ahead and I saw that the specimen on my table was not there. The specimen just wasn't there, which was not possible. Kyunki har table pe specimen pada tha, and obviously like specimen should have been there. So I asked my teacher that the specimen isn't there, and she got really angry at the workers, and she said ki jaake special examination specimens leke aao. So the workers, the clerks, everyone went around searching for the specimen for around good 20 minutes, half an hour. They kept searching for the specimens and they couldn't find that single sole of foot. So my anatomy teacher got really pissed at them, and she said, "Ke, theek hai, fine, just give her palm of hand." And there it is. Guruji helped me through it. So palm was one thing that I knew thoroughly, and I knew that any question asked from it, I'll be able to answer. So that's how the first time Guruji really helped me pass through the exam. Right after that, so in MBBS, we used to have like continuous exams for 20 days without even one day of gap. And I remember this was like the 20th day, and I told my mom that, "Mama, I have no patience to give another exam. This is the last exam and I don't think I'll be able to appear for it. I have not slept for so many days. I have just studied. I don't think I'll be able to do it." And when mom heard this, she was like, "Let me tell you satsangs of Guruji." And this is how I got introduced to Guruji, because mom kept telling me satsangs, and she used to go to satsangs, and at night she used to call me. I was there in Manipal doing my MBBS, and she used to call me every night and she used to tell me satsangs. So right before the exam at 2 a.m. in the morning, she was like, "Ke pata hai Panam, I heard this satsang that if a Sangat member can't come to Guruji's mandir, Guruji himself comes and gives them darshans in the moon." And when I heard that, I really wanted to try it out for myself. I was like, "Really, Guruji is going to come and give me darshan? That's amazing." So I went everywhere. I went to my room window. I couldn't see the moon. I was in the girls hostel at that time. I went to my room ka window. I couldn't see the moon. Then I went to the top floor, which was the 6th floor, and tried my luck on the window of the 6th floor. And there it is. I saw it was full moon that day. And I looked at the moon, stared at the moon for a good 3 minutes and remembered Guruji. And there it was. Guruji's darshan in moon, which was a big deal for me. And it was there for good another 5 minutes. Thank you so much, Guruji, for those miraculous darshan. It gave me thrills, and it was the most amazing feeling in the world. Right after that, I used to have trouble in waking up early hours and attend classes during my MBBS time. So that led me to shortage in my attendance. They had always told us that if you don't have like good 85% of attendance, you won't be able to appear for the exams. And So I had shortage in my attendance. And immediately when I got to know about it, I called up my father and I told him that I don't think that I'll be able to appear for exams this semester. It was my second year and second prof. And so dad immediately told me, do Ardas to Guruji. I'm sure he will take care of everything. And there it was. Guruji arranged 10 extra classes for me. And this had never happened in the history of my MBBS that they could arrange extra classes for someone so they could cover up their attendance. So I remember I used to attend those 10 classes even right before the exam that Guruji had specially arranged for me, and I could cover up my shortage of attendance. Thank you so much, Guruji. Right after that, Guruji has a way of attaching you to them. You know, the pull that there is, that each one of us has felt, I'm sure, the different kind of connection that we all feel with Guruji. So every time I used to go back home, all I wanted to do was, like from Manipal, when I used to go back home, all I wanted to do is attend back-to-back satsangs, go to mandir, be in that vibe of Guruji, and just absorb how much ever positivity I could in that time. So right at that time was my birthday, and I told Guruji, I'm coming to Delhi and I want to spend my birthday with you, like completely, utterly surrendering to you this birthday. I really want to spend it with you. So, and I remember it was a non-sangat day, so I couldn't come to mandir. So I prayed to Guruji for a satsang that could happen. But my mother asked around a lot of sangat people. I asked around all my friends, but in those days, the satsangs was not so common. So we really couldn't pick on one satsang anywhere around my house or anywhere in Delhi for that matter. And so we decided to just go for lunch that day. I remember going to Green Park Market and talking to my mother about ki, and I was very curious for everything, you know, Guruji's birth, life history, Guruji's life, the Shabad we were listening to, which I had never heard in my life. And so I used to be very curious. So I remember asking my mother, ki mama, what is the meaning of this shabad? Sa dharti bai haryavali jithe mera satguru baitha aave. And she very nicely explained it to me that, Panam, it means wherever my guru will sit, that land will prosper. And immediately when I heard the meaning of that shabad, I immediately connected to Guruji, and I just kept imagining how beautiful it would be if Guruji comes and sits in front of me, and how beautiful that vibe would be. And right after leaving from the market, right outside the market, I saw a house which was decorated very beautifully with flowers. And I just thought to myself, maybe this is a satsang that I've been looking for. And very shamelessly, I asked my driver to ask the guard. And I remember it was 4 p.m. in the evening. And the optimism that Guruji gives us, I saw that I made my driver ask the guard. And the guard bhaiya said that, yes, this is Guruji's satsang. And it has just started. And I was just so happy that Guruji finally called me to his satsang. And all of us were there with me, all my family members. And so we entered the satsang. The moment we kept our foot inside the house, we heard the same shabad. Sadharti bhai haryavali jithe mera satguru baitha aave. And instantaneously, you know, the instantaneous connection that Guruji drives to you is just so beautiful. Thank you so much, Guruji. So one of those days, I remember I came back from Manipal, took my flight, and I asked my mother, ki mama, please, mujhe na rajma khane ka bahut man kar raha hai, can you please cook it for me? And I remember we were supposed to go to mandir that night. So mama said that I haven't prepared anything, Pana. Maybe later I'll prepare it for you, but right now we have to go to the mandir. So, and still, you know, in my mind, I really want to have rajma. and we went to the mandir, and there it was. Guruji had made sure, you know, to make us feel home every time when we go to his mandir, and there it was. There was rajma prasad that day in the langar, and henceforth in every satsang I went to, there was rajma prasad. Like, he just loads you with a lot of love. So I used to miss going to the satsangs, and I remember when I was leaving Delhi that time, I had come for 2 months, and it was very difficult for me to leave Delhi and go back to Manipal that day. And I was in a very foul mood, and I kept on throwing things in my suitcase that, okay, fine, we'll just go back to Manipal where I can't go to mandir, I can't attend satsangs. I was throwing things, and I remember my sister was doing something with the glitter, and I picked up that glitter and I threw it on the table. And I was in very bad mood, and I just kept on thinking that when will I come back to Delhi? When will I get to be with Guruji again? And I couldn't even believe in just fractions of second that glitter turned into a huge om. So that was Guruji's way of saying that he is there with me every step of the way. So I went back to Manipal, and by Guruji's message, I started doing small satsangs in my room. And in one of those satsangs, one of my friends got really connected to Guruji, and she wanted to know more about Guruji. So I gave her the book Light of Divinity, and I asked her to read it. I think in just 2 days, she finished that book and she gave it back to me. And we used to be very busy. It was the exam time, and we used to be very busy studying for exams. And I remember she met me near the lift, and she said that she's having some medical issues. So I asked her what is going on with her, and she said she has hemorrhagic cyst of the ovary. And I was really scared to code, because I knew that it could rupture any time and she could land up in emergency. So I was very worried for her, and I told her to take care of herself. After 2 weeks, since we got very busy, we had our exams. Right after the exams got over, she came up to me and she said that after 2 weeks, she got her scans done and there was no cyst to be found. That's how Guruji blesses your friends, your relatives, everyone around you, just not you. How beautiful is that? So right after that, I gracefully finished my MBBS, and I was doing my internship, and I got this dream that Guruji is sitting on a rath. He's wearing a white chola, and I'm standing on the balcony. He's sitting on a rath, and the rath is flying away from, right away from me, and I see Guruji is staring at me, like, with a very bad look. He's just staring at me, and he's trying to pull away some negative energy, which is in the black form, and I could see it very vividly, that he's trying to put that negative energy from me, and he's just staring at me. And when I woke up from that dream, I was in sweats. And I remember that I was sure of the fact that Guruji has blessed me with a very big thing. And just at that time, I didn't know what it was. And right after around 2-3 months, Guruji came in my dream again, and he said, "Ki navi pant lele." And I just knew that every time what Guruji says, I have to follow that at that very moment, because it has a very deep meaning to it. So I was very busy in my pediatrics posting. We used to have night duties every night. And even during that, I told my mother to buy a new pair of jeans for me. And she bought one, and she sent it from Delhi to Mangalore. And in just 2 or 3 months, I met with a very bad accident, and that very night I had to undergo a surgery, which was really bad, so much so that my parents flew from Delhi immediately and took care of everything. And I was on bed rest for good 6 to 7 months. I was brought back to Delhi and was well taken care of. Right after 6 to 7 months, I started my internship back. I came back to Mangalore, and while working for good 2 months, I fell sick again. I saw that my leg had turned red and I couldn't walk at all. So I sent a picture to my orthopedician and he said, "You immediately come here and get an x-ray done and show me." So I got an x-ray done, x-ray of my leg, and showed it to him. He said that your screw has broken and you will have to get another surgery done. I just couldn't swallow what he had said. I just couldn't believe, because getting another surgery done was a big deal, because only I knew how painful the first surgery was. So I called up my family. They immediately flew down to Mangalore, and I came to Delhi to consult more doctors. Immediately when I came, I knew that I couldn't walk. My leg was red, probably some cellulitis or something, some infection was happening. And I had already taken few appointments with the doctors. So next in line was Mahashivratri, just after 2-3 days of me landing in Delhi. And so my father told me, just before you go to the Bada Mandir, just before you go for your doctor's appointment, you should go to Bada Mandir and take Guruji's blessings for Mahashivratri. And even though I wasn't so comfortable, since I just couldn't walk, I still just agreed to it. And I remember I had a doctor's appointment at 2 p.m. on the same day. So I went there, and I remember it was 2 p.m. already in the car because of the traffic. I remember like there were a lot of Sangat members who would come there. And so by the time I reached the mandir, I knew I couldn't have gone to the doctor's appointment. And I just went ahead with going to the mandir. And obviously, it gives you a lot of positive vibes being in the mandir. And just absorbing that positive vibes maybe just makes you feel so much better. I went to the mandir, had Langar Prasad, and came back and slept that night. The next morning when I woke up, I was totally fine. I was that fine that I was running up and down the stairs. It was like I got a new leg, and it didn't even feel like I was not well the previous day. So such is Guruji's blessing. So miraculously, such divine blessings that he makes you feel like the magic world you're living in. Like I didn't even ask for it. And Guruji cured me. Thank you so much, Guruji. Right after that, I started preparing for my post-graduation exams. Very seriously, it took me like a year to prepare for those exams. And just after giving the exams, we have to appear for counseling. So before the counseling, me and my mother went to the mandir, and we went to the mandir and we went inside the hall, and my mom would instantly connect to Guruji at that time. And I saw that she was talking to Guruji, and I really wanted to know what it was. So we both prayed to Guruji, said our shukranas, and we went out of the mandir hall. And right outside, I immediately asked her that what is it that she was talking to Guruji about. She told me that Guruji had told her that I have to take the seat in respiratory medicine, which is the pulmonary medicine. And immediately when she told me this, and I thought to myself that this is such a boring branch. I don't think I want to take it. But yet I respected his decision and I went ahead with my counseling. I did all my research for all the subjects. I thought of taking ophthalmology, thought of taking gynecology, thought of taking medicine, surgery, everything. I took my chances and I did my research and went ahead with the counseling. Just one day before the counseling, my dad had this dream where Guruji came and he said, "Ke ennu respiratory medicine leke deni hai." And that morning when I was going to the counseling, my dad came up to me and said that you have to take this seat. And to my surprise, even though I had thought of taking other subjects, I was only left with that seat. That is just so miraculous. I can't tell you. It was like I was gifted that seat in my lap. And I went ahead with it. I took respiratory medicine. So just because Guruji told me to take this seat, every time I felt that I was lacking somewhere in my stream, I used to tell myself that Guruji made me get this stream and it's going to be perfect. It's just going to be perfect. So right after 2 years, COVID struck. And yes, that comes under my stream. And I was so scared to probably deal with everything, with every small thing. I remember COVID was so new for us and me being just a kid out there. I was very scared since we didn't even have PPE kits available in our hospital and we had to go into the COVID wards. I know like most of us now have had contracted the infection, but at that very moment, it was very scary. I remember my 60-year-old HOD walking in front of me without the PPE kit and not even being afraid of contracting COVID. So I couldn't have been the one to say that I won't go in. So I remember on Facebook live satsangs, I heard one auntie saying that there is a special message for the doctors. She said that everything you do in the hospital, every procedure you do on a patient, every patient you treat, just keep Guruji in front of you. And that's what I did. I remembered Guruji being there with me. I kept Guruji in front of me and went ahead with everything, even without PPE kits. I remember contracting the virus in the first wave itself, and Guruji made me sail through it. So that was the time Guruji gave me the indication to do meditation. I remember how I started with meditation and how beautiful journey I have been through in my meditation. It's just Guruji's blessing. It's just so amazing. So one of those days I had to give my theory exam of my final post-graduation theory exam. And it was just 1 month into giving my exam. And I remember I was studying since early morning, 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. I was studying. And around 11 a.m., I got really hungry. I was sitting in my room with all my books spread on the floor. And in between all that chaos of books, I was sitting and reading. And at 11 a.m., I felt very, very hungry. And I thought of getting up and getting a food for myself. So my phone used to be connected to the Bluetooth speaker inside the room. And I got up, I went outside the room to open the fridge and find something for myself. And that happened. So I picked up an apple and something happened, that telepathy happened with Guruji. And he asked me to play that Shabad, I'm just forgetting the name of the Shabad, that one second. तो जो शब्द था, आई एम वेरी सॉरी संगत जी, मैं भूल रही हूँ अभी उस शब्द का नाम. दैट वॉज बाय सिद्धार्थ मोहन. एंड उनका जो जिस्ट है उस शब्द का कि मेरे सदगुरु प्यारे हैज कम, वो आए हैं हमारे घर. एंड मैं बहुत खुश हूँ. आई रिमेम्बर दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट शब्द. And that is what was playing. And the moment I like, it was so beautiful ki, like Guruji has set up the whole thing. And, you know, he's prepared me for every moment possible. And that's how beautiful it is. The moment I enter the room, I see Amrit flowing through all the walls. There's Amrit on the table. अमृत वर्षा हो रही है वॉल्स पे, टेबल पे, फ्लोर पे, पूरा देर इज लाइक होल ह्यूज वॉटर देर. इट वॉज सो ब्यूटिफुल एंड आई वॉज जस्ट टेकन अ बैक विद दैट शब्द प्लेइंग ऑन द स्पीकर. लाइक आई रिमेम्बर इट वॉज 11 AM एंड आई वॉज सो हैप्पी दैट गुरुजी हैज कम टू माई हम्बल अबोर्ड. थैंक यू सो मच गुरुजी, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट ब्यूटिफुल ब्यूटिफुल ब्लेसिंग. सो आई रिमेम्बर मेरी शाम की मेडिटेशन में आई सॉ जो गुरुजी के मंदिर की तरफ से मंत्र जाप आता है, तो वो मंत्र जाप के टाइम पे आई वॉज मेडिटेटिंग एंड सो देर इज ये कनेक्शन है मेरा और गुरुजी का कि वेन एवर आई टेल गुरुजी कि गुरुजी आप जब भी मुझसे खुश हो प्लीज कम इन पिंक चोला एंड दैट्स व्हाट आई टोल्ड गुरुजी एंड दिस इज बिटवीन मी एंड गुरुजी. एंड आई रिमेम्बर दैट मॉर्निंग आई वेंट टू द हॉस्पिटल एंड आई टुक द रिक्शा टू गो टू द हॉस्पिटल and the rickshaw wala who came to pick me up, I was like very sillily I was bargaining with him ke ha bhaiya itne paise mein aap please le jaiye mujhe hospital tak. And so he took me to the hospital and I asked him ke bhaiya you can leave, agar aapko jana hai to aapne drop kar diya hai mujhe, although mujhe wapas bhi jana hai. So he said, no, no, I'm right here, don't worry. And you go do your stuff. So I had to go to the hospital just for like 10 minutes. It was a 10-minute job. I remember it was meri tab prep leave chal rahi thi exam ke liye. And so the moment I'm done with all my work inside the hospital, I come out. And that rickshaw wale uncle is right there in front of me. And then I'm like, okay, uncle, please take me back to home. And I decided to pay him. And that's when subconsciously I didn't even think of anything. And in my evening meditation, I saw that Guruji had come in form of that rickshaw wale bhaiya. And the moment this message came to me, I got up and I thought, Guruji, you have to give me an indication that it was you. And the moment I opened my eyes, I saw Guruji was wearing pink chola. That's how beautiful it is that Guruji made me believe that he came to bless me in his physical form. So right after that, second wave hit and everyone in my family had symptoms. So it started with my dad. Mere dad ko sabse pehle bukhar start hua tha. एंड उनको कुछ चार दिन के लिए बुखार रहा एंड फोर्थ डे पे आई रिमेम्बर बिकॉज मेरे डैड को वेगनर्स है. वेगनर्स एक कंडीशन है जो कि बॉडी के सारे ऑर्गन्स को इन्वॉल्व करती है. तो आई न्यू कि उनको ऑलरेडी वेगनर्स है और उनको अगर कोविड हुआ, अगर वो सीवियर हुआ तो इट विल बी नॉन सैल्वेजेबल. So yet being so scared, मुझे ये भी पता था कि डैड स्टेरॉइड नहीं ले सकते थे क्योंकि उनकी आई में यूवियाइटिस है और यूवियाइटिस में इट्स कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड, मतलब स्टेरॉइड नहीं दे सकते. तो ऑन फोर्थ डे ऑफ डैड फीवर मैं गुरुजी के सामने बैठी एंड मैंने गुरुजी को प्रे किया कि गुरुजी आपको ही संभालना है एंड I know that this is way beyond me. मैं कुछ नहीं कर पाऊंगी इसमें, आपको ही संभालना है. And right in that moment, I felt immense coolness around my third eye and I connected with him instantaneously. And मुझे पता था Guruji is going to take care of it. And that's what happened. उसके बाद dad को fever नहीं आया and everything was like a smooth sail. And right after that, everyone got affected. गुरुजी ने सबको ठीक किया. ही टुक केयर ऑफ एवरीथिंग एवरीवन एंड वी ऑन द कॉन्ट्रेरी वी ऑल टुक स्टेरॉइड्स. राइट आफ्टर दैट आई रिमेम्बर राइट आफ्टर द कोविड गॉट बेटर आई गॉट वायरल कोलेसिस्टाइटिस व्हिच वाज अ पोस्ट कोविड थिंग दैट हैपेंड. एंड आई जस्ट कुडंट ईट एनीथिंग. मैं कुछ नहीं खा सकती थी. आई हैड टू बी ऑन अ लिक्विड डाइट और अ सेमी सॉलिड डाइट विच वॉज वेरी वेरी नील. एंड तीन चार दिन में गुरुजी केम इन माई ड्रीम. एंड मैं ये सोचती थी कि गुरुजी वट एवर इज हैपनिंग, आपको पता है ये कि वट एवर इज हैपनिंग विद अस. एंड आई रिमेम्बर कि जो ड्रीम था दैट वॉज राइट इन आर हाउस एंड आई एम जस्ट अबाउट टू एंटर आर मंदिर, घर का मंदिर. मैं बस एंटर ही करने वाली हूँ एंड मैं ये सोच रही हूँ अभी कि गुरुजी क्या आपको पता है ये कि क्या हो रहा है हमारे साथ. एंड द मोमेंट आई ओपन द डोर मैंने देखा कि गुरुजी अपनी गद्दी पे बैठे हैं. एंड मैं अंदर आई, आई वॉज सो हैप्पी. गुरुजी को देख के मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई. एंड गुरुजी को जैसे ही मैंने गुरुजी को देखा, गुरुजी ने कहा कि हाँ मैनू पता है, मैनू सब पता है. एंड वी बोथ स्टार्टेड लाफिंग एंड इट वॉज जस्ट अ मोमेंट दैट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू फ्रीज थ्रू आउट माई लाइफ. दैट लाफ्टर ऑफ गुरुजी दैट आई फेल्ट इन माई ड्रीम, आई थिंक आई हैव रीलिव्ड इट many times. So yes, if the condition did get better, and right after that I got a very nice job offer and I took the job. It was all Guruji's blessings. So day before yesterday I fell sick again. I felt the same pain again where I couldn't eat anything and it was a very bad pain. And just that I was saying ke how Guruji satsang ke through bless karte hain, I was in very bad pain. I got injections also. I got painkillers and everything. And it was in the middle of the night. And I had very bad ward duties, ICU duties. And I didn't know how I'll be able to manage with so much pain. And I just played the satsang. I heard satsang throughout night. And through the pain, Guruji ne itna zyada bless kiya. Ki I could only sleep after 6 in the morning. And after that, since yesterday I've been totally fine, eating well, and I got all my tests done today and they are all negative. I'm totally fine, my liver functions are normal, my CBC is normal, all my tests are normal. And so it happened ke today's satsang that happened, that there was a patient that we had been following up for around 2 weeks. The patient came with bilateral pneumonia, dono taraf bahut bada pneumonia tha us patient ka, and right side mein pani bhara hua tha, like pleural effusion tha. And I remember with no fever. So this kind of presentation of a patient with no fever is very rare. So the whole doctor's team that I'm a part of, sab bahut surprised the ki ye kaise ho sakta hai ki fever nahi aaya hai patient ko, how is that possible. And sab ne bahut investigations kari, we were trying to investigate the patient, antibiotics de rahe the, sab dawaiyan de rahe the. And I remember I was discharging the patient today and I saw ki he was wearing Guruji's band and I said ki aap Guruji ko mante ho. So he told me ki yes, he's been following Guruji since last 20 years. And how miraculously Guruji ne unko bless kiya hai. He had a cancer, oral cancer, and Guruji has treated him. And henceforth, there was no fever. Thank you so much, Guruji. In that very moment, I felt ki jo Guruji ke paas aa gaya, usko kuch sochne ki zarurat nahi hai. Kuch bhi sochne ki zarurat nahi hai. And how he blesses each one of us is so miraculous. Thank you so much, Guruji. And so because of my ill health, I cannot have chai prasad. I can have chai prasad, I can't have chai. And I remember today itself, I was very busy in the wards in ICU. And I went to the sister, the head sister, kuch ward mein kam tha, vacutainers nahi the. So I went to her to ask her ki what is this condition, I can't even find vacutainers ward mein, bahut zyada problem ho rahi hai hum logo ko. उसके बिना तो काम हो ही नहीं सकता. एंड आई वेंट ऑन टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ द वार्ड एंड आई सी सो बिजी एंड आई वॉज टेलिंग हर दैट एंड इमिडिएटली शी वॉज प्लेइंग मंत्र जाप. सो आई थॉट कि ये क्या चल रहा है, आज तो सिस्टर के सिस्टर जी ये क्या चल रहा है. तो शी फॉलोज गुरु जी. सो आई वॉज जस्ट यू नो इन माई माइंड ही चीज है कि अच्छा आप भी मानते हो गुरु जी को, चलो चाय प्रसाद पीते हैं. सो दे आर जस्ट प्रिपेयर चाय Chai Prasad, and we went on having Guruji's satsang for 10 to 15 minutes. So such is Guruji's blessing that he made me have Chai Prasad right inside the hospital. Thank you so much, Guruji, for every small blessing and for the big ones too. Thank you so much, Guruji. And that's how, where I want to just say one thing, that with Guruji, I think the सबसे अच्छी चीज ये है कि यू कैन जस्ट लीव ऑल योर प्रॉब्लम्स टू हिम एंड जस्ट गो अहेड विद लाइफ. जैसे गुरुजी बोलते हैं कि हमेशा ऐश करनी चाहिए, तो आई थिंक वी शुड टोटली पॉजिटिवली फॉलो दैट. जब इवन व्हेन वी आर इन प्रॉब्लम्स, आई थिंक वी शुड डिटैच आवरसेल्फ फ्रॉम दोज प्रॉब्लम्स एंड लिव इन द मोमेंट, थिंकिंग कि लीविंग एवरीथिंग ऑन गुरुजी and still believing that he'll take care of everything and just being happy in the moment, whether even if it's tough. I think staying happy and detaching yourself from the problems is very, very, very essential. Thank you so much, Guruji. Thank you, Sangatji.